Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In today's episode, I'll show you a small framework I've developed for adding context menus to tables and trees without actually subclassing them each and every time. Okay, so how do you add a context menu to a widget? Well, there's a few different ways. Let me just show you from the documentation. I'll move over a bit so you better can see it. So first off, we have no context menu. Okay, that's not adding context menu. Actually, it kind of is, because if you specify that, then it's a parent widget that will get a chance to add the context menu on the right mouse button being pressed. Okay, next one, prevent context menu. That one says, no context menu whatsoever. Okay, we'll skip that one too. Then there is default context menu, which is what we did in the good old days when I still had hair and everything. And that is simply to override the context menu event on the widget and it'll be notified. Then there's the action context menu, where you can add a bunch of actions to the widget and it will make a context menu out of these. And finally, there is custom context menu, which will emit a signal, and from that signal you will act and put up the context menu. So Jesper, you have four different ways of adding context menu. Why couldn't you just use one of those? Well, let's go through them each and every one and see the disadvantage. The one going to the parent, the no context menu, obviously that's not going to help me much here. The default context menu meant that I need to subclass, which was somewhat difficult if I had a hierarchy of multiple levels and I wanted to add my context menu actions on each of those. The signal, well, on different levels of the hierarchy, which of them should actually win and how would I go from one to the other? That was actually the most difficult part I had with that. And then the most promising one was the actions context menu, because at different levels I could just add that action, but that did not have the capability of adapting the text according to which item I was clicking on. So with that said, let's see what the actual work looks like. So let me just show you the example here. I'll move over again. Here I have a table, and if I right click somewhere, I see a context menu and I can just negate that thing here. I can also paint in red, and what you did not see, but what we could have done there, was that each of these actions could be telling me exactly the item that I was right clicking on. And that's one of the features of this whole mechanism. Let's go and see the code. As always with Qt Widgets and More, I have a main where I do everything in, and do not copy that at home, but it's just to make it easier on you. I create my Qt application. I create an instance of Qt Widgets and More table view. Hey, yes, but didn't you say something about not subclassing anymore? Well, there's one subclass that now is the subclass to use. So you just, everywhere where you previously had QTableView, just have a QWidgets and More TableView, and then you'll have support for these context menus. My QWidgets and More TableView, I'm setting it up with a model, easy peasy. Now, here is where the new code starts. My view, add context menu action, that's similar to like add action on QWidget, except that it's my class, not a queue action that I add. And you can see for memory management issues, I move it over here. The negate action is an instance of this action class. I specify the title, so negate. I specify what to do whenever that action is being triggered. I specify a function here, which will, on that particular item, tell whether it should be enabled or not. And similar, I can specify whether it should be visible or not as a fourth parameter. Anyway, as you can see, let me just run it here. You can see that when I right click here, I can negate, but if I have something selected and I right click, it is disabled because, well, somebody told me I couldn't negate a whole selection when I wanted to show you this piece of code here. Now, as I said just before, I can also change the actual title on the fly, and That's one of the features of this framework here that I use very much. So if we go and look at action here, we can see that it has two different constructors, one taking a title and one taking a title function. And the title function is just a function which takes the model index that I right-clicked on and return a string. So let me just go over here again and adapt this code here. And I'm back again, typing really fast. As you can see, if I right-click now, it says negate 12. So obviously I know that I clicked on 12, but the data might be a cell that represents a person. And in that cell, it tells whatever, it's his name. And then I right-click and the context menu could say something like, change Jesper's hair color away from gray, or whatever it was about. And there it's useful to actually go and get the data from the item. The framework also support submenus in here. That is actually pretty easy specified. Just give a path where you separate each element in the path for down to the menus with a forward slash. Let me show you the code. So here's the code. We have I'm creating a method in here that takes a name and a color. And that's just so that I can add a number of items here right away. So add color blue should be blue and red should be red and so on. And what I do in here is that I set up this function here called paint. The paint function takes a Q model index, but it doesn't need that model index for anything because, well, I will paint the whole selection. So it's just to give you an idea that I can actually do more than just the items that I'm on. But at least for me, the most common use cases was to do something just on a single item, like change the name of this person or show me how profitable this particular person I right-clicked on and so on. So I have my selection here. I go to my selection model and ask for selected indexes set, and I iterate through each of the selection here and I say model set data to be this background color on the item. And I add this new method that I created here to my context menu, make unique for the action here again, and paint slash, that's how it goes into a paint summary. I can also add separators. As you can see here, I have a special one of my subclasses of my action base. So separator action base, that one specify also the path down. So here it's just paint, but it could have been paint slash change color slash whatever for having a deep menu structure underneath there. But it's just on the paint here. Add context menu, and you could argue, and Pepe did argue with me, and we agreed to kind of disagree on that it wasn't that big a deal. That separator is not really an action. So maybe a stud variant with action and something else would have been a better idea. And I have other things to do than just record videos for you, you know? So anyway, enough said. Add color clear to be cute white here after my action. There is a number of situations where I want a predicate to tell based on the model index whether an item should be enabled or even visible. And for that purpose, I created a small library of these. And remember the code that we had here for my negate action. On the third parameter here, it says only one cell selected, giving a view as a parameter. Let me show you the library, because there's a few just nice C++ things in that library. At least when I took our C++ 11, modern C++ training, it was called 11 back then. That was one of the things that I took away from using lambda expressions. I've showed you before, but I really like it. So let me take you there. So all these functions that I'm going to show you all takes a Q model index, which is the index of the cell that I right clicked on, and it returns true or false. And they're used for should this menu entry or this entry in the context menu be enabled or not, or should it be even visible or not. As you can see, is valid model index, for example, here, it takes that index and it simply returns whether it is valid. It's simply a matter of making the code more readable on the client side. Instead of writing all the square brackets and parentheses and braces and whatnot to write this code here. I will simply write the text is valid model index. What? Did I miss the true one? You're wondering what it's true about? Well, for the parameters of the, well, let me just show you. That's easier. So over here, I'll go down. There we are. You can see the action, as we've seen a few times before, takes the title, the action function, and then defaulted is whether it should be enabled or not, or whether it should be visible or not. And these two are always true. So that's why I have this function called true. Let's also go down here and look at this method here, only one cell selected. This function actually takes a parameter and it doesn't return a Boolean. It itself returns a function. So this function here returns a lambda expression that is the one taking the content, the model index, and returning true. And it doesn't even use the model index, but you can see it tests whether, well, let's start. It will count whether the selected index from the selection model of the view is equal to 1. So exactly only one cell selected. Let me go over to the main here. I actually prepared a bit for you. I modified the code while you were watching kitten videos or whatever you were doing while I was doing this. And in here you can see this is the original version here, the less cool version. This is the version that I could have written. I could have written negate action is this action here. It takes this string. That's what we looked at before. It executes this. And then here is the code for checking whether it should be enabled or not. And as you can see, it binds the view. It takes a model index that it doesn't use. You see, it takes me mentally a few seconds to read what goes on in, oops, do not select, what goes on in these lines of code, while the cool version up here, namely, just has this only one cell selected. And assuming that I didn't mess with you when I wrote this function, you can just read here, it's an action, it does all this stuff that is already too much for me, then negate function, and then only one cell selected on my view. I personally like this style of taking my writing lambda expressions or functions that returns lambda expressions and take some parameter to make the whole code more readable and easier to read whenever you later on maintain the code. Thank you for watching. Wait, don't go away yet. Let me just complete my sentence, will you? Thank you for watching yet another episode of Qt Widgets and More. And as you know, all the code in the Qt Widgets and More series is MIT licensed, so you can cut it right out and put, do not go yet, I said. You can cut it out and put it into your own code base. But please do wait until the next episode is out, because in the next episode, I will geek around a bit with the code and make the usage of this framework so much more pleasant. Okay, I will throw away the need for the unique pointer and so on, but there's a few very interesting, for me at least, lessons learned. So stay tuned, and then next time, cut out the code and use it. Until then, have a great time.